Hey Cubesters, welcome back to my channel, and welcome to part one of my cube collection video. I also wanted to say a huge thank you for 200 subscribers on my YouTube channel. I really, really appreciate each and every single one of you guys. Hopefully there will be a giveaway coming soon, so stay tuned for that. And here's what we'll be looking at in today's video. Enjoy! Cube I'll be starting out with is my first ever Rubik's 2x2. It obviously doesn't turn super great considering it's a Rubik's puzzle, but it's my first ever 2x2, so it is pretty special to me. The second 2x2 I got was for my, I believe, my 11th birthday, and this is the GAN 249. It is non-magnetic, and I wouldn't really suggest getting it, and I know a lot of people were disappointed with it, but if you're into GAN puzzles, I mean, go for it. The third 2x2 I got was the YJU Po V2M. And this has a little koala cubicle sticker. This is supposed to be one of my siblings' puzzles, but I ended up taking it since she never used it. I believe this is the MFJS 2x2. It still sounds a little gummy because there's lube in here that hasn't been used considering, you know, it's broken. A couple pieces popped off when I had it in my pocket, but other than that, it's a really great starting 2x2. This is a Mofeng puzzle. I have no idea what it is. It's not good, obviously, anymore, as you can tell. This piece broke a little bit right up there, and this piece is just missing somewhere. I have no idea when I got it. It was definitely a couple months ago, but it was meant to be a keychain, and like the other puzzle, or other two that I showed, this one has also lost a piece. But for like a backpack or something, it's very fun to have. The seventh puzzle I got right when the pandemic was starting, and I supported the cubicle by buying this, and then they donated this money that came from this logo, which is great. This is the Macaroon MFJS puzzle, and it's very good, and for collectors, I would definitely suggest this. And my newest 2x2 is the GAN 251M, and the logo's barely hanging on there, you can't really see it. But this, if you're a fast turner and you have pretty accurate turning, I would definitely suggest this for you. It has medium magnets. It's a classic GAN puzzle. It barely pops, and it's just really, really good all around. So yeah, let's go on to 3x3. My first one I got when I believe I was 8 years old, and it's a very old Rubik's brand, so this has the old technology, and it's really slow, and you can see how old it is by the logo. My second cube was a little something like this Cyclone Boys, just a different one, and it got lost, unfortunately. But I have this new one from a friend, and it's pretty trashy and loose, and just don't get Cyclone Boys, please. This came in a set of a 2x2 through 5x5 cubes. I'm not sure the name. I believe it was MFJS, though, as the brand, and it's not super great, but if you're a slow turner, then you'd probably be fine off with this cube. This is a tiny modded cube. I got the 3x3 that's under this in 5th grade, and I decided to mod it, and this is my first and only modded puzzle. I just super glued the pieces and cut some origami paper to fit it, and obviously now it's gotten extremely dirty, but these used to be bright, vibrant colors, and I think it's just a pretty cool little thing to have. This is the Angstrom Worm WRM. I won this from a cubicle giveaway a couple months ago. It's gotten pretty dry and hard to use since I haven't used it in a very long time. But if you're looking for a good controllable cube, I would highly, highly suggest this. And it looks really bad now, but that's only because I haven't used it. And if your Angstrom dries out, put some D&M in there, and that should help a little bit. So a while ago, I got this from my stepsister as just like a little gift. And I really appreciate that, and it can be used as a keychain cube. There's a hole in one of these corners, but it's pretty cool just to have. These are all dollar store cubes coming up. So this is a maze cube. It's extremely hard to turn, and I don't know where the balls that go to it are. So yeah, no, just wouldn't recommend it. It's cool to have though. We have the Joker picture cube, a fruit picture cube. We have a smiley face picture cube, a star picture cube. And I got all these back when I was trying to sell stuff on my cubing website, but it was kind of pointless, so I just kept them. This is another fruit cube. Another Joker cube. This is something my stepsister also got me when we were staying somewhere, and it was at an arcade. And it's super fun and like interesting to look at, as you can tell in the light. It's very trippy, but it's cool to have. And then a while ago, I didn't have my first 3x3, so this was actually probably one of the first 3x3s I got. I couldn't go without it for 2 days, so I had my mom take me to the dollar store to buy one of the trashy cubes so I could peel off the stickers and color it with Sharpie. The orange and the red look very similar. That's why I had to put these X's there, but yeah. Pretty trashy cube. Just don't get cubes from the Dollar Tree. Buy from the cubicle. This is my R3M2020. I set it up a little bit. It's pretty fast, and if you're looking for a good starter cube, for only $9 you can pick this up and save 5% with code CUBESTER at checkout. And this was an extremely, extremely popular cube because of how good its like corner cutting and speed and all around just technology is for its very low price. So yeah, would highly recommend this cube if you're starting out. I believe this is another MFJS puzzle. I got it in the pack with the 2x2 that I showed previously. And it's very good. I would suggest it for starters, and I set this up with some adherin and angstrom compound X. So yeah, super cool. And this was the limited edition cubicle logo. This is the Go Cube that my mother got me for Christmas. Shout out to my mom. It's super fun. The app isn't super great, so if you're looking for a good app, I wouldn't really recommend the GoCube. But I do know a lot of people like the Rubik's Connected, so I would aim for that. This is, I believe, the Shang Xiao Gem. I got it from a $3 mystery puzzle pull, and it's turned into a logo cube where I try and match the logos to the color of the side. So far I have a couple on there. I have to add more to here, so in my next order I'll probably get some new logos, but not a good cube to solve with. It is fun to just sort of mess around with, and I don't know, just to have. This is another MFJS puzzle. I've loosened it because it was too tight. Now it's probably too loose. It's stickered very trashy because I used duct tape to sticker this because I didn't have any application tape. Otherwise, I would have gone over my budget. And it's not done well. I would not suggest the cube, although it is only $3, so you kind of get what you pay for. This is the Chi Thunderclap V3. I got it on sale for, I believe, $5 or $6. I'd say it's worth it for the price. The corner cutting isn't super great, though, which I don't really like, and it's not magnetic. But if you're looking for a cheaper puzzle, I would maybe go with this, but there are better options out there for a couple more dollars. And then my most recent cube is this metallic Rubik's 3x3, and it had candy in it, but I just find it insane how crazy they line it up. Sometimes I still have issues finding where the line is. So yeah, super cool, and I really like it. Let's get on to 4x4s and big cubes. All right, here I have 10 big cubes to show off. And the first one, I don't have my first ever 4x4. That would be in part two. But this is the Rusu 4x4. It's very loud and obnoxious. And although I may look turning, or it may look as if turning this thing is easy, but it tends to lock up quite a bit. And you can sort of hear it and see it just like that. So, oh shoot. That's not good. Anyways, yeah, don't get this cube. It's not good. My main 4x4, however, and my most recent 4x4 is the Chi MS, and I would highly, highly recommend this cube. There is a little bit of an issue with it being too tight, but it's pretty unnoticeable, and it corner cuts very well, as you can see. And I know a lot of people likening the GAN 4x4 because it's, you know, a GAN puzzle, and you'd expect it to be very well. But I did try it out myself recently, and honestly, this $10 4x4 is much better than the probably $60 4x4 you'd pay for from GAN. This is my first 5x5. It's also from the MFJS brand. It's extremely slow and just not good to turn at all. This is my most recent 5x5 and my main. I got it for Christmas. Shout out my mom. This is the Yushin 5x5. It's a little slow. I put too much Angstrom Compound X in here. But it's magnetic. You can kind of hear it, and I really like this cube. This is my first ever and only 6x6, also by Mofeng Jiaoxi. If it would focus. There you go. It's pretty trashy, it turns slow, it's stickered, gross, don't get it. This is my first 7x7. I forgot the brand for some reason, but I know I have this MI7. This is the second version of it by Qi. Both by Qi. This one's better though. The first version is somehow better than the second, and the second version is also bigger. My most recent MI7 and my main is the YJU Proof V2M. It's very fast. There's not much of an issue with corner cutting unless you have inaccurate turning. And yeah, it's a really nice puzzle and also magnetic. And I just like the way the magnets sound when you turn it. This is my first and only 8x8, also made by Mofeng Jiaoxi. It's pretty good, and it's fun for slow solves, long car rides, or airplane rides. I would highly recommend getting this cube. And my biggest, first, and most recent 9x9 is by Yushin. This thing is a monster. For reference, let's use the RS3M 2020. So if you have this at home, just reference that. That's insane. It's basically double the size of an RS3M. And for the Qi MS4x4 users, this is also referenced. So it's massive, and last time I solved it, it took me a couple hours and my hands cramped up very bad. So super cool to have. I really like keeping this pattern on it just to show off. And if you're a big cube lover, then you would very much so like this puzzle. This is my first ever Pyraminx. I got it from my aunt. I believe this was early last year, possibly 2 years ago, for my 12th birthday. And it's a Qi Jelly Pyraminx. It turns all right. Although I don't think it's really meant for speed cubing. It's really cool to look at, especially since you can see the internals very clearly. And I would highly recommend this cube for collectors. This is my only cube. It's pretty terrible. It's a carbon fiber cube, so you can't really expect much from carbon fiber cubes, but they are cool to have and to look at. This is one of my two square ones. This is made by Chigi. I wouldn't really recommend it. If you can save up, I would definitely get a better one. But for now, it's all right. If you're a beginner and you're looking for a cheap cube, then I would probably get the Yushin square one. I've heard lots of good things from it, and it's pretty much $5, so get that one. And these are my three Megaminxes. The first two are made by Qi, so they're the same thing. They've slowed down since they've gotten dirtier as they sit around. And here's the other one. But for beginners, I would probably recommend this cube. Although, if you like faster turning cubes, I would get the Shang Xiao Megaminx. It's smaller than the others, although it does come in stickered. They'll probably have stickerless, but I just really like this cube. And I think you might too. So, yeah, these are my WCA event cubes, including my 3x3 that I forgot to include, which is my main, aka the Diane Tangyan 3x3. Very good cube, I like how it turns fast, and there's basically no issue with corner cutting. However, if you aren't an accurate turner, do not get this cube unless you know how to tighten things, because boy does it pop. Alright, let's get on to mods now. I believe the Qi something 3x3. It's meant to be on a keychain, and it's actually very fast for being a small 3x3, and it's really cool to have, so I would highly suggest getting this. This is one of my first tiny puzzles, was the world's smallest Rubik's 3x3 produced by Rubik's. I got this at a Target a couple months ago, and you can indeed take it apart on like their old Rubik's 3x3s. So yeah, pretty cool to have, and I really like just looking at it because it's fun. This is the $1 cube I got off the cubicle, which turns pretty decent for being $1, although it does catch a lot like many, many cubes do. So just cool to have. And this is a Qi Pillow Jelly 3x3, also meant to be on a keychain. And it's just sort of another fun thing to have. So yeah, these are all of my mini 3x3s. Let's start off with 3x3 shape mods. The first one I have, I got a while ago, was the, I'm not sure what brand this is. It might be Qi, but this is a golden mirror cube. I got this for my birthday, and it's really fun to have. And if you look right, there's my ring light. there's my stand. Hi. Okay. I got this cube. It is the Pandora cube. It's really fun to have. It turns pretty well. The only issue is that when you turn, obviously these guys stick out, and I do have an issue with getting scratched. So if you don't mind getting scratched while solving a neat cube, then you'll be all fine. This is one of my two windmill cubes. I really like windmill cubes for some reason. I don't know why. They're just fun to have and solve. They're basically a step up from 3x3, so if you can solve 3x3, you won't have much of an issue solving the windmill cube, and you'd probably like this cube a lot too. Next up are 3x4 gear cubes. These cubes were made by Chi and mass-produced, and they're very, very well made. This is the Chi 3x3. It turns much better than a lot of other gear cubes that I've seen people have. The only issue with gear cubes that I have are getting pinched, which can be annoying, but you'll get used to it. This is the Chi barrel cube. It's a little dry, but I also haven't used it in a while, so it does come factory lubed, and it's just a really cool puzzle to have. Although I think all gear cubes are the same as well. This is the Sphere Chi gear cube, super cool, and it's literally the same thing as the 3x3, just easy to get pinched, but very cool. And I got these three cubes plus one in a set for cheaper on thecubicle.com. And the last one that I have is the Rubik's Void cube. It turns pretty bad and you can get parity, so I wouldn't recommend it unless you're a collector. One of my first non-3x3 cubes, or non-WCA cubes, was an Ivy cube. This one sounds very dry, but it's because I brought both of mine to camp, summer camp, and they got very dry with sand in them. And I found it funny how this is the same brand, but they have to be two different versions because, as you can see, when you line the stickers up, it's wrong. And that's orange, that's red. But you can mainly tell the differences when these two blues come on. They're extremely different, and this one's pretty stained from my bag. So, yeah. Ivy cubes are really, really simple to solve, and they're a great first cube to get. This is the Chi Mastermorphics 5x5, and just no. This is the Rubik's Void cube. It's really fun to solve, although there are limited tutorials online. I made one myself, and you can go check that out if you'd like. These are my two 2x2x3s. They're probably a step up from the 3x3. And if you know the 3x3, then you can probably figure this out pretty easily with a tutorial or two online. And I have two of these guys. A 2x2x3 mod that I have is this dinosaur. This is one of my two dino cubes. The other dino cube will be in part two. And I'm not sure what this one is called, but they have plenty on thecubicle.com. And you can get them in a set and save 10%. And you can save even more money using code CUBESTER at checkout. So the dino cubes are really, really great for collectors. And if you're into cubography, get these. Just don't even hesitate. Just buy them. And this one is actually called a dino cube, although it's not a dino. It is fun to have. The sticker has a little issue with peeling, but it's really simple to solve. I just had to look at the instructions packet that came with it. But yeah, pretty cool cube to have and very simple to figure out. Thanks for watching today's video. If you enjoyed, like, comment, and subscribe to my channel. Turn on post notifications if you'd like to know when I upload a new video. And if you'd like to check out my other socials, including Gmail, Instagram, etc., those will be in the description of my video. If you have questions, comments, or concerns, leave them here or DM me on Instagram. Thanks for watching, and I hope you have a fantastic day. Bye.